Hello everyone, today we are going to do standard 6, 7th chapter, symmetry. So children, before starting with the chapter, I would like to inform you all that we have started with the live sessions. So on Monday, we are going to have live session with the 5th standard. Live session for the 6th standard will be on Wednesday and 7th standard will have live session on Friday. Whereas 8th and 9th standard will have live session on Saturdays and Sunday. Okay, so please attend it. If you all have any queries, you all can join me on my live session and ask the questions so that I can solve your queries. All your sums will be solved over there. So please join during the live session. The timings will be from in the afternoon, that is from 3 to 4, 1 hour. So try to join it if you all are having any problem solving the questions. So let's start with the lesson. So symmetry is the lesson that we had last year also. Okay. What does symmetry mean? So symmetry means that whichever diagram or alphabet, numbers, which can have a reflection symmetry is known to be a symmetrical figure. Okay, so I'll read the statement. If a symmetrical figure gets divided by an axis, this is an axis in the figure, into two equal parts, the two parts should be similar to each other, which fall exactly on each other, its symmetry is called reflectional symmetry. Got it? In short, when the axis, this axis can go in this way also. Okay? Whichever figure or diagram is been divided by an axis in two equal parts, that figure is said to be a reflectionary symmetry. Got it? So, alphabet A, H, M are few examples of reflection symmetry. There are many alphabets which can be divided into two equal parts, two similar parts, not two equal parts, I can say two similar parts. Okay, so these are few figures, diagrams, you all can say. There are few figures been given which can be divided into equal axis. Now see, this figure cannot be divided in this axis or this axis. If we divide this figure in this axis, then only we will be able to get two similar figures, right? For A alphabet also the same thing happens. If we divide it from this axis, then only we will be able to get two similar parts on both the sides. Whereas in this figure, if we divide the figure with this axis, we will get two similar figures. Whereas if we divide it from this axis, we will get two similar figures. Got it? So you don't have to draw two axes, you have to only draw just one axis, okay, in order to show the symmetrical figure, right? So moving towards practice set number 20, hope this concept is clear, reflectional symmetry. Now moving towards practice set number 20, they have asked us a question. Children, I'm doing these questions from the textbook and showing the figures from the textbook so that you all can communicate, you all can relate to it. Draw the axis of symmetry of each of the figures below, which of them has more than one axis of symmetry. Now, as I said, over here only one axis is there, but over here there are more than one axis, right? There are two axes, right? There are two axes. In the same way, we have to find the figures from these figures which is having more than one axis. Right, so for that what we have to do, we have to take a scale and then see whether we can divide it in two equal parts. Okay, so see, if we divide from this axis, we will be able to get two equal parts, right? And if we draw an axis from this in this way, then also we will be able to get two equal parts, right? So this is a symmetrical figure which is having more than one axis. Okay, so you have to draw this figure. In the same way for triangle, you all have to check. If we divide it from this axis, check it, we will get two similar figures, right? If we divide it from this axis, forget about this axis now, okay? So if we divide it from this axis, whether we will be able to get two similar figures? Yes, we will be able to get two similar figures, isn't it? Two similar parts will be there. Okay, again, if we divide it from this axis, we will be able to get two similar figures again. So this figure is also a symmetrical figure which is having more than one axis. Now for this, if we divide it from this axis, we will get two similar figures. But if we try to divide it in any which way, you will see that we won't get the similar figures, right? So this is not the figure that we need. This is only one axis symmetrical figure. Now for plus sign, if we divide it from this side, children, you all have to draw this figure and show the symmetrical axes, okay? So we can divide it into equal parts. Again, if we divide it from this way, if we draw an axis in this way, we will get two equal parts. See these two equal parts, right? So a figure, this figure, and even this way, if we divide it in this way, if we draw an axis in this way, same figures we will get. Similarly, in this way also, if we divide it, we will get a same figure on both the sides. So this is also a figure which is having an axis which is having more than one axis. Okay, so children, you all have to draw this figures, and after drawing the figures, you all have to draw the symmetrical axes also, okay, and show how many axes it can be divided. Okay, so draw it. I'm not drawing it, I'm directly doing it in the textbook for you all to understand it. Okay, write the capital letters of the English alphabets in your notebook. What does this mean? You all have to write A to Z. Okay, try to draw their axis of symmetry. What does this mean? We have to draw the axis of symmetry. Like they have shown it over here, na? A, H, M. In the same way, you all have to write A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J. Till Z, you all have to write it, and then you all have to draw the symmetrical axis. Okay, and show from which axis it has been divided. If it has not been divided, you all can write it. It is not having any axis of symmetry. Right? So, I think you will be able to do this. This question was there last year also. So, I think you all can do this. Use color, a thread and a folded paper to draw a symmetrical shape. So, if you don't attempt this question, it will be okay. It can be given as a practical for or activity from the school. Observe various common seeing objects such as tree leaves, birds in flight, pictures of historical buildings, etc. Find symmetrical shapes amongst them and make a collection of them. These two questions will be asked by the school teacher to do it for the activity. Okay, so be prepared with these activities, children. You all have to do it on your own. I hope you all have understood what to do in this question. So you all have to attempt only two questions from this exercise. Okay, practice at 20. Now children, for this you all have to pay attention. This is a little hard. If you understand it, it will be very easy. I'll try to explain it in a very easy method so that you all will be, the concept will be clear for you all. So drawing symmetrical figures on a graph paper. Now before this, you all were able to draw figures on the paper, but now you all have to draw it on a graph paper. So how are you going to draw it? See, suppose this is the line, okay, and this line shows that two equal figures have been divided. Okay, A and B and A dash and B dash. Now how you have to do it, children? See, you all have to first count the lines. See, from here you all can directly count because you all are having from the graph paper. I think you all are able to see. Wait, I'll zoom and show you. This much only can be zoomed. See children, you all have to count the small lines and the big lines and then mark this line. This will be given to you all. You all have to count these small lines which have been given, and then in the same way you all have to mark the points over here also. Okay, I'll show you for example. See, this is from 1 and 2. Okay, 1 and 2. From here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Got it? Means from this figure, what they have done, they have taken the sixth line from the y-axis and 9 points from the x-axis. Got it? From this and this way. So once you jot this point, do it over year also. For year also, what you have to do? You have to take 9 points on the x-axis and 2 points on the y-axis. Got it? Then you will get this point. Mark this point. After that, what you have to do? You have to see this point. Now, children, for this, you all have to check each and every line where it is joining. Okay? So, after they have joined in, you all have to mark the same points. Keep on counting from here and from here. From here and from here. From here and from here. Got it? For this also, you all have to first see the x-axis and then the y-axis. First the x-axis and then the y-axis. Got it? Then there will be no confusion. The only rule for following these kinds of diagram, and these diagrams are going to come in the exam for you all to draw. So the only rule for this, to draw these diagram in the simplest way, is to follow the x-axis and y-axis rule. Okay? In the same way, they have given two more questions. I hope you all have understood this question, children. Got it? Count from x-axis, jot the point. From y-axis, count the point. And the same way you all have to mark on the other side. I will be showing this in the exercise so that it will be more clear. Now moving towards these type of questions can also come in the exams. You all have to just recognize whether they are, these are easy to recognize. Okay, that these have been already drawn. You all have to just recognize whether they are symmetrical or no. Whether they have the exact measurements or no. So how are you going to check? For that also you all have to use a scale C. Right? Both are at the same point. Okay, then check this point. Same. Then check this point. This is also same. Then check the other joining point. This is also same. And when you check this one, if it is coming in a straight line, then and then only these figures are symmetrical. For that you will have to check, see this point over here. You will see, now after this you all have checked the x-axis. What about the y-axis? For y-axis, what you all have to do? See, for y-axis it is very easy to check because you all can directly measure it. For x-axis only it is difficult. For that you all have to use the scale. But for x-axis you can directly check. See, this is right, this point is also right, but these points are wrong. Over here, see, they have joined to this axis. Okay, at that 10 point they have joined in. Is it zooming? Yes. And over here it has not joined, it has joined at the point 9. Okay, so these figures are not symmetrical. Got it? There will be a minute change, you all have to just recognize it. Moving towards this question, same, in the same way, use a scale, measure according to the scale. See, is it same? Yes, it is same. Is this same? Yes. The x-axis are all almost same. See, it is same. Then these two points, check it. Yes, they are same. Yeah. Now over here you will see that this is 1 2 3 1 2 3. Yeah, these figures are also in the same point. You all have to count it, children. Okay, if the scale is not clear, you all have to show it. Okay, after showing it only you will be able to recognize it. Now x-axis is clear, go for y-axis. Y-axis, this is touching. See, now this point on the y-axis is touching, whereas this is on the 9th point. Got it? Whereas this is touching the 10th point. So this is not a symmetrical figure. Again we can see that, see, this figure is coming inside and this figure is going outside. See, this part is outside and there is no outside part over here. Got it? So children, check this diagram in your notebook, textbook also. You will be able to recognize that these two figures are not same. Okay, they have asked us the question, in the above figure the line divides the figure into two equal parts. Does these two line falls exactly on each other? Verify. So these two diagrams are not equal. They are not following same on each other, exactly same on each other. Why? You all have to say whether it is the problem is with the x-axis or the y-axis. Okay, so in this diagram the problem is with the y-axis, whereas in this also you all have to count the points and then write it. Okay, hope you all have understood how to recognize these in exam. This question also can come. Okay, so let's start with the difficult part, to draw the reflection symmetrical figure. Okay, so these diagram I have already drawn, and we have to just make a replica of it. Now how are you going to draw it? I'll show you. Children, be very careful. Okay, so when the figure is joined we have no problem, but when the figure is like this we are going to face some problem. Okay, so be ready for this figure. So first count, how many points are there? Is it zooming in? Yes. Now count, one, two, three, suppose this is 5, 6 and 7. So what you have to take, this is 5, 6 and 7. Put a point over here and then draw this line. Children, you are able to see this, how I took the points? I counted this points first and then I have drawn this figure. Okay, now the second point is this one. For this point, what you all have to do? You all have to count from 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so what you all have to do? You all have to place it over here. First, you all have to put a point and then draw the line. Okay, just don't draw the lines because these lines are very small. If one also line misses, your figure is going to get wrong. Got it? So, we got this point. After that, which point is coming? This point is coming. Right? So, keep this straight and draw your this point. Okay, after that it is going upward, so where you have to go? You have to go downward. Downward how much? Till the dark line. So you all have to take this till the dark line. Got it? First step is this and then you all have to take this step. Okay, so this step has been done. After that what we are doing? This is 5, 6 and 7. So I have 5 over here, 6 and 7. Got it? Children, you all are able to see this figure properly. Try to count these numbers. Number wise only move your figure. Then join this. Okay? Now this line is done. After this what we have to draw? We have to draw this till here. Okay? So what we have to do till 1. So from here 1. Draw this. Done. So this point is also done. After this, which point we have to take? We have to take this point. Sorry children, this is zooming and zoom out because I have zoomed in a lot. So this is like the picture is going and coming again and again. Okay. So we have got this point. From this point, what we have to do? We have to draw till here. So draw the point. See this point. Draw this. Okay, so we will get this point. Now what we have to do? We have to move till here. So move your figure till here. Okay, count it. After 5, 6, 7, after 5, 6 and 7, draw your line and very slowly and steadily do it. Sorry, my line has been crooked, so I'll erase it and draw it again. Yeah. Okay, got it? Now after this what you all have to do? You all have to just join in this figure. Got it, children? In this way you all have to draw this reflection symmetrical figure. This was easy, this is also easy. Okay, so now what you all have to do? You all have to count 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2 and 3. So first point is going to come over here. Wherever the first point is coming, you all have to do it slowly and steadily, keep on increasing your figure. After that the next point is coming over here, 5, but before 5, 6 is there. So from here 6, 5 and 6. This dark line, little dark line is 5 and this is 6. So, draw this figure. Okay, then draw it in this way. Wherever it is joining in, you all have to first mark the point and then join it. Then what we have done, 1, 2 and 3. So, 1, 2 and 3. So, the point is coming over here. Mark the point. After that, which point you are going to mark? C. Over here. Fifth. So, you all have to draw. And from this fifth, y-axis we have taken. Now, we will take x-axis. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5. So, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. Now, the next, after marking this point, we have to move to this point. This is 5 and 6 on the x-axis and y-axis 7. So, x-axis, what? How much we have to take? We have to take 6 and y-axis we have to take 7. Till here, 7. Okay, so not this point. First mark the x-axis. Six, na? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 and 8. So, mark it on the 8th point, this point. And from here, 1, 2 and 3. From up, that is on y-axis, 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so we have got this straight line. Got it? Now, join it. Got it, children? Is it looking similar? Yes, it is looking. Now, from here, how much points do left hand side I have taken it? 8. I'll count in this way. This was 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Over here, I will mark this point. Okay, so I got this point now over here. From this point, what I have to do? I have to mark the point on this over here. So, from 5, 6 and 7. So, from 5, 6 and 7 over here. After this point, which point I have to mark? I have to mark this point. Children, you all are able to see this? Yes. This. So, you all have to mark it on the 1, 2 and 1, 2 over here. Okay, and your last point is over here, that is after 5, means a 1 centimeter, 10, 11 and 12. So 10 is over here, 11 and 12. Got it? When you take x-axis, y-axis is automatically going to come because we know how much distance we have to take. So, we have got a line. Okay. After this, what we have to do? We have to join in. Okay, children. This figure is looking similar. Okay. It will take a little practice and lots of patience. Go it and do it very slowly. Now.